Welcome to the penultimate chapter of the APU series. Currently, the aircraft is in flight. The right engine has failed. The left engine is providing thrust, bleed air to operate the pneumatic systems, and generator power for the electrical systems. To assist the main engine, the APU is running and supplying a second source of electrical power for the aircraft systems. Except for providing backup power when there is a main engine failure, the APU is not used for the majority of the flight hours. When the APU is operational in flight, the open position of the inlet door located behind the rudder increases aerodynamic drag, and when the APU is turned off, the inlet door closes and remains flush with the airframe, not contributing to the overall drag. To further minimize drag at the empennage, the Boeing 777 is equipped with a flatter tail cone. And to accommodate this design, the APU exhaust duct is angled 13 degrees to the left. The reduction in the base area of the tail cone ensures more laminar flow and improves aircraft performance. The APU power is not critical during a single engine failure, as one main engine can handle all essential operations. Before going into the dual engine failure situation, let's look at a few more essential systems of the aircraft, starting with the engine and APU fuel feed system. The fuel feed system has engine fuel manifolds, APU supply line, crossfeed valves, engine spar valves, and APU fuel feed valve. The feed system also has 7 fuel pumps, a single APU DC fuel pump, 2 AC boost pumps for the left wing tank, 2 AC boost pumps for the right wing tank, and 2 AC override pumps for the center tank. 3 AC pumps pressurize their respective manifolds. The center tank pumps have higher output pressure than the wing tank pumps. This ensures the engine first consumes the center tank fuel, and once the center tank is empty, the wing tank fuel is consumed. When the APU is selected, it receives fuel from the left engine manifold. The APU DC pump is controlled automatically by the electrical load management system and only runs when AC power is unavailable. The pressure loss in the left engine manifold will trigger the load management system to activate the DC fuel pump and supply fuel to the left engine and the APU. As a backup to all pump failures, the underwing-mounted main engines have a suction feed line. The gravity feed works when the main engine is running and no pumps are operating. Suction feed is not possible for the APU and requires pump operation for fuel feed. Once electrical power is restored, the pumps will override the suction feed. The left main engine is also powering the 3 independent hydraulic systems of the aircraft. The left system is pressurized by the left engine-driven pump and the left electric demand pump. The engine-driven pump is mounted on the gearbox and operates when the engine is running. The left electric pump is available and will run whenever the demand on the left system increases. The right system is pressurized by the right engine-driven pump and the right electric demand pump. Since the right engine has failed, the right engine-driven pump is unavailable. The right electric pump will take over and pressurize the right hydraulic system. The center system is pressurized by 2 electric primary pumps and 2 air-driven demand pumps. The center electric pumps are operating to provide the center system pressure. The left engine integrated drive generator is the current power source for all 4 electric pumps. If the demand on the center system increases, the air-driven pumps will automatically operate using the bleed air from the left engine. When the aircraft suffers a dual engine failure, it will lose the engine-driven hydraulic pump and the integrated drive generator. With the loss of the AC power source, the electric hydraulic pumps will shut down. And with the loss of engine bleed, the air-driven pumps cannot operate. The aircraft has completely lost its thrust, hydraulic and pneumatic power. The only available power source is the limited electrical power from the main battery. The main battery directly powers the standby DC bus of the aircraft, and with the help of a static inverter, powers the standby AC bus. The standby panel part of the load management system powers the critical AC and DC loads. The battery is a time-limited power source and does not operate the hydraulic systems. Therefore, the loss of both main power panels will trigger the electrical load management system to use the battery power to perform 2 automatic simultaneous functions. Deploy the RAM air turbine, and auto-start the APU. Ignoring the switch position, the load management system will run the APU fuel pump, activate the APU controller, and open the APU inlet door. the APU controller will bypass the switch logic and perform the electric start using the APU battery. By the time the APU comes online, which could take up to a minute, the ram air turbine deploys within 2 seconds and starts supplying electrical and hydraulic power. The propeller of the ram air turbine, driven by the airstream, operates an electrical generator and a hydraulic pump. The RAT generator supplies power to the standby AC bus. The load management system will disconnect the battery and use the transformer rectifier unit to power the DC standby bus. Let's look at the systems that are available when the RAT generator supplies electrical power. The standby bus only operates the critical loads required to control the aircraft. Critical loads include a few communication and navigation systems. Limited flight instruments and display panels. Standby power will also help recover the main engines by supplying power to the engine igniters for in-flight start. The standby panel does not power the electronic engine control, and since the pneumatic power is unavailable, the starter cannot be used. Therefore, a windmill start has to be attempted. In flight, even when the engines are not running, the forward motion of the aircraft will turn the engine shafts. The N2 shaft connected to the transfer gearbox drives the accessory gearbox. When the N2 speed is more than 7%, the EEC alternator mounted on the gearbox supplies power to the electronic engine control. The engine start switch is not required for windmill start and can be performed by directly placing the fuel control switch to run. As the APU DC fuel pump is already running for the APU auto start procedure, it will also supply fuel for the left engine start. The engine spar valve will open, and the fuel will reach the engine's high-pressure fuel pump. The EEC can now control the ignition and fuel flow into the combustion chamber. But to accomplish this, the engine must reach the minimum N2 speed. If the N2 speed is less, the airflow compression is not enough for a successful combustion. The N2 speed now depends on the airspeed of the aircraft. If the airspeed is insufficient, the N2 speed will not reach the threshold, and the EEC will abort the engine start attempt. Without any thrust, the only way to increase airspeed is to dive the aircraft, and for that we require flight controls. Each primary flight control surface is operated by multiple power control units for redundancy. The PCUs are electrically controlled and hydraulically operated. The standby electrical panel provides electrical power to control the center system PCUs. The RAT hydraulic pump pressurizes the center hydraulic system and only has the capacity to operate the aircraft's primary flight controls, providing control in 3 axes. With only one PCU operating and not all control surfaces available, this will reduce the controllability of the aircraft. High lift devices that help reduce the approach speed for landing cannot be extended. Center system powered spoilers are available and can be used as speed brakes to help reduce airspeed in flight and stop the aircraft after landing. Landing gear normal extension and retraction are unavailable. To perform an emergency landing, an alternate extension can be used. The hydraulic power pack using the standby power will give enough hydraulic pressure to release the landing gear locks and allow them to free fall to the extended position. After extension, the main gear truck tilt, nose and main wheel steering will not function. Normal and reserve brakes are unavailable. To help stop the aircraft after landing, an accumulator stored pressure is available for the landing gear brakes. The accumulator provides enough pressure for 6 full brake applications. Without pneumatic power, the pressure inside the aircraft's cabin will begin to drop. Now let's see how the scenario changes when the APU comes online and starts supplying electrical power and bleed air. The APU bleed will operate the air conditioning and pressurization systems, preventing depressurization and emergency oxygen deployment. The APU generator has the same output capacity as the main engine generators and can run all essential loads of the aircraft. Complete communication and navigation systems will be restored. To monitor and control these systems, full cockpit instruments and display panels are available. As the main panel AC power is available, the left wing tank boost pumps will operate, and the APU DC pump will be switched off. Since the APU is supplying the bleed air, the engine can be started normally using the air starter and does not require high airspeed. The EEC will open the starter valve. The starter will drive the gearbox and ensure the N2 speed reaches the threshold required for selecting the fuel control switch to run. The EEC will activate the igniter plugs and open the engine fuel valve. The EEC now has a better chance of recovering the main engines. The main panel AC power will also operate the electric hydraulic pumps and pressurize all three hydraulic systems. The electrical and hydraulic systems will operate all power control units and primary control surfaces. The aircraft's normal handling characteristics will be restored. To assist the primary control surfaces for roll control, all 14 spoilers are available. With full center hydraulic system power, the flaps and slats can be extended for an approach speed safe for landing. When the center hydraulic system demand increases, the air-driven pumps will automatically run using the APU bleed and share the load with electric pumps. The center system will also power the normal landing gear actuation with proper sequencing. The doors will extend first, followed by the landing gears, and then the doors will retract. After extension, the landing gear truck tilt will function to provide damping on touchdown. After touchdown, the right hydraulic system pressure will provide unlimited application of the normal landing gear brakes. To help slow down the aircraft and maximize braking efficiency, complete speed brakes can be deployed. Even though the left and right hydraulic system pressure is available, the thrust reversers cannot be deployed as the engines are inoperative. The nose and main wheel steering are available to control the aircraft and prevent it from veering off the runway. In the final installment of the APU series, we will explain the APU protection systems. Thanks for watching.